Hoarding is where you just keep piling shit up in your house or piling shit up in your car. I see it all the time. There's people that drive around with shit just packed all the way to the top. It's illegal to drive like that. You can't see. These people literally have shit up to here, all the way up. It's like they can't get rid of stuff. And I'm speaking from experience, y'all. I was like this. Every little thing that I accumulated over the years, I was like, oh, I'll need this because... Good afternoon, everybody. Demise Music and Entertainment. This video is about the mindset, psychology, philosophy, right? It's all about the mindset. So I was thinking about this last night and I was like, wow, the inside of somebody's car or the inside of somebody's house or their bedroom is a reflection of how they feel on the inside. And when I was thinking about that, you know, it's always when I'm about to go to sleep or I'm awake, like, so I'm in that half asleep, half awake flow state, so I'm not even overthinking. I'm just kind of in like semi-dreamland, and that's when a lot of ideas come up. And when that happens, you have to get out your freaking note, pay it, and write that shit down, because that is when your mind is really, really working. A lot of people don't understand that, and they're like, oh, you know, it's just, I'm dreaming. But no, it's like, that's really important stuff. That's how a lot of people come up with great inventions and ideas. What I was saying was, the inside of someone's car, or the inside of somebody's room, or house even, or apartment, is a reflection of how they really feel on the inside. And when you're eating fast food a lot, and when you're eating unhealthy chips, hot Cheetos, and fucking sodas and all that, what you're doing is you're hoarding your body. You're being a hoarder of unhealthy shit in your body, and you just consume frozen corn dogs, Hot Pockets, hot Cheetos, chips, sodas, hamburgers, fast food stuff. So you're hoarding your body with all kinds of unnatural stuff. Hoarding is where you just keep piling shit up in your house or piling shit up in your car. I see it all the time. There's people that drive around with shit just packed all the way to the top. It's illegal to drive like that. You can't see. These people literally have shit up to here, all the way up. It's like they can't get rid of stuff. And I'm speaking from experience, y'all. I was like this. Every little thing that I accumulated over the years, I was like, oh, I'll need this because I haven't used it yet, but I'll need to use it in the future. And it was just all this stupid stuff. I had a box full of pens that I never touched, but I kept saying, oh, I'm going to use them. I would have a box full of clothes that I would never wear, that I was like, I should give these a Goodwill, I'll do it another time. I had a box full of other shit. It's just stuff that piled up to where when I had to move, I was like, this is never ending. I'm gonna move all this shit. So then what my brother told me, my brother Rick One, he said, man, I've moved around so much in this life that I've consolidated my life down to just a few boxes. And that fucking struck a chord with me. I was like, wow, man. I've been moving around a lot too, and it's a pain in the ass. And moving around a lot, and then having my brother tell me that you need to consolidate into many small boxes, that's when I was like, okay, that is what I need to do in order to make my living situation easier, moving situation easier. And overall, when you, they call it minimalists or minimalizing, when you get rid of 70% of the shit that you do not need, there's a weight that lifts off your fucking shoulders. There's a deep breath that you can take, and you'll start to see and notice more clarity in your mind. More clarity. It's a mindset. When you're over... Okay, so here's how my cars used to look, right? First car I had, I bought from my mom's friend, and it was a good car. That's before I really went down the fucking deep end. This is before I went all depressed on them, right? But I crashed that car. And then by the time I got my second car, thanks to my mom, I was not in the right mindset. I was like 20 years old. And I was an alcoholic. Okay, I drank every day. I smoked cigarettes all day, every day. All that fucking bad shit. My rooms... Wherever I had a room at the time, it was just completely filthy. The inside of the car, I'd get a cigarette burn here. I'd get a cigarette burn there. Other people would come in and they'd accidentally burn cigarettes here and there, and then I would drink in the car. Not necessarily drink and drive at the same time, but, you know, I'd sit in the car and I'd drink a few sips of beer or something like that, and then it was terrible, guys. I'm telling you from experience, it's not good. I'd spill the beer on the ground. My friends would spill their beers on the ground. We'd be smoking cigarettes in the car and the ashes would fall on the seats. You could just tell. I fucking would purposely, like, run into people that were trying to fucking cut in front of me and stuff, like bumper cars. I didn't give a single fuck. And it was a reflection of how I felt on the inside. The trunk of the car was a complete fucking mess. There was, like, broken CDs everywhere, pens, some type of liquid oozing, and probably, like, it was broken, and water was coming in from the rain. I'm telling you guys. And the room, I don't even want to go into what the room looked like. The room was beer stains all over the floor. Under the bed, I would just, like, have a bunch of shit and just toss it under the bed. There was a time where I started smelling something hella putrid, and it was a dead mouse under the bed. I was like, what the fuck, man? To get that dead mouse, I had to fucking take everything out, and it was just like an opening, eye-opener, like, all right, you have too much shit. You need to get rid of a lot of shit, because this is not how, you know, this is not a good way to live, kid. And it's crazy, because I'm 28 right now. I know a lot of people that are like 40, 30s, 40s, 50s. Life beats you the fuck down. Life beats you down, I know. And that's a reason why a lot of people hoard, because it's, you know, they might have lost a parent, or they might have lost somebody, and so a loved one, and then they just start accumulating shit. But there's no excuse for that shit anymore, guys. There's no fucking excuse for hoarding. And you gotta have clarity of the mind, okay? You will find yourself saving money. You will find yourself being more clear-minded. Trust me, guys, my car now is fucking, I keep it as clean as possible, okay? I tell my girlfriend, hey, take that wrapper out, please. You know, it's like an OCD type thing. And then when I do get my own condo or my own home, okay, it's gonna be just immaculate. I want it to be not spotless. I don't give a shit about, like, super, super cleanliness, but organized. I just want it to where I walk in, it's just clear, clear-minded. I know where, when I'm in the kitchen and I want to make some bomb-ass food, maybe some pasta, some little tortellini over here, I could just have my fucking eyes closed and just be like, boom, stove, boom, spatula, knife, ding-ding-ding, all in the same spot. And when it's done, wash it, put them back. No dishes left in the sinks at all. None of that, okay? So your car, I've seen people's cars where it's full of shit. Full of just wrappers, Starbucks things here and there. Fucking candy wrappers on the ground, shit everywhere. And people might say, well, we have kids. That doesn't fucking matter. I have a kid too. And I'm going to show my kid the good habits of being clean and clear-minded and not hoarding, okay? Don't ever blame anything on the kids, people. I went from being a complete, absolute mess, hoarding, to getting rid of like 75% of my shit, which was one of the hardest things I had to do, because I said, this is holding me back, okay? I have to change. Threw so much of it away, gave so much of it away, gave my grandma my bed, you know, focused on what I really wanted, which was my music, and then everything else I just pushed out of the way. And now, it's like I'm back to ground zero. Clear-minded, and once I get my own place, clean, clear. All right, guys. Demise Music Entertainment, thank you all so much.